us to identify the explicit formula for the sequence 1, 3, 7, 15, 31, and so on. So one place to start is you can try to look at what is the difference between each of these. So the difference between 1 and 3 is 2, 3 and 7 is 4, 7 and 15 is 8, and 15 and 31 is 16. So we notice that each number is increasing by a power of 2. Because we have 2 is 2 to the first, 4 is 2 squared, 8 is 2 to the third, and 16 is 2 to the fourth. So now we also notice that if we look at our numbers, 1, 3, 7, 15, 31, if we add it on the next power of 2, so 32, which is 2 to the fifth, we see that each one of these numbers is 1 less than the successive powers of 2. So what I mean by this is 1 equals 2 to the first minus 1. 3 is 2 squared minus 1. 7 is 2 to the third minus 1, and so on. So what we have here is that our explicit formula is going to be 2 to the n. So n is the term that we're on. So for the first term, 1. N is 1. For our second term, 3, n is 2. And we are subtracting 1. So a to the n, our term in the sequence, equals 2 to the n minus 1. Here we have another sequence that we want to find an explicit formula for. 1 third, 2 fifths, 3 sevenths, 4 ninths, 5 elevenths. So when you have a sequence that is a fraction, it's often easier to look at the top part and then look at the bottom. Okay. So if we're looking only at the numerator, we see that the numerator is just n. That it's, you know, so for our first term, the numerator is 1. Our second term, the numerator is 2. So to get the numerator, that's just n. Now on the bottom, this one's a little trickier. So we have the difference between each of these is just 2. So that means that we have 2 times n. And then how do we get 3? So if n is 1, 2 times 1, we need to add 1. So if we check it, if we have, for our second term, 2 times 2 plus 1 is 5. So our denominator is 2n plus 1. A sub n equals n over 2n plus 1. We want to estimate the limit of the sequence numerically from the explicit formula and then estimate the limit graphically. So we have a sub n equals negative 1 divided by n plus 3 for n equals 1, 2, 3, etc. So if we make a table, we have n and a sub n. If n equals 1, then we have negative 1 divided by 1 is negative 1 plus 3, and that is 2. If n equals 2, then we have negative 1 half plus 3, so that's 2.5. If n equals 3, we have negative 1 third plus 3, so that is 2 and 2 thirds. If n equals 4, we have negative 1 over 4 plus 3, so that's 2.75. If n equals 5, we have negative 1 fifth plus 3, so that's 2.8. If n equals 6, we get negative 1 sixth plus 3, so that's 2 and 5 sixths. If we look at 7, we have 3 minus 1 seventh, so that's 2 and 6 sevenths. If n equals 8, then we have 3 minus 1 eighth, so we are getting 2 and 7 eighths. For 9, we get 3 minus a ninth, so that's 2 and 8 ninths. And at 10, we're getting 3 minus 1 over 10, so that's 2 and 9 tenths, which is also 2.9. So we can see that we're getting very, very close to 3. So we're going to estimate that the limit of the sequence from our numerical table. So we're going to estimate that our limit is 3. Now we can also estimate this graphically if we were to graph all of these terms. So when n is 1, so we have n down here and a sub n on what's usually our y-axis. When n is 1, we get 2. When n is 2, we get 2.5. When n is 3, we get 2 and 2 thirds. When n is 4, we have 2 and 3 fourths. When n is 5, we have 2.8. 6 is 2 and 5 sixths. 7 was 2 and 6 sevenths. 8 was 2 and 7 eighths. At n equals 9, we had 2 and 8 ninths. And at n equals 10, we had that a sub n was 2.9. So we see that we're getting very, very close to 3 graphically as well. So that confirms that we would guess that the limit of the sequence is 3.